Welcome to downtown Brooklyn, USA, inside the beautiful Atlanta Center Mall. Buffalo Wild Wings and the NYC Top 100 Players, powered by Under Armour. I'm Joby Smith, along with NYCSN President Vernon Joes. An exciting night indeed, because we're going to unveil the Top 100 Players of NYC Basketball. And Vernon, it's been an exciting season thus far. These guys really put in some great performances, but it's really a great time now to give them the honor.
Right. Well, it's the end of May, the beginning of June. The season ended a while ago, so it gave us a chance to really take in what the players did during the regular season, what they did during the playoffs, and also it gave people opportunity to nominate plays and just talk about the plays that they think would be in the top 10, top 20, and the top 100.
Well, it wasn't easy coming down to the finalist list, but we had a lot of nominees, a lot of coaches and players weighed in. Of course, our members on nycbasketball.com gave their opinions, and we arrived at that list. So why don't you tell me how we got there?
Well, the way we get there is, first, we watch the plays. We go out, we watch the plays. We go out, we talk to the coaches as we're watching the games. We talk to fans, we talk to everyone. And we, you know, the bottom line is we watch the players, and we also allow people to nominate players and to talk about players. For example, we have the nominations where people, they put up the nomination who they would like to nominate. But then we also, one thing we really liked was the blog that we created and said, if you could take 10 players from New York City, the top 10 players, and go to Chicago and play the top 10 players in Chicago, who would you pick? That was, to me, that was really telling, because that's when it kind of, you saw certain names on everyone's list.
It's always debatable, and of course, everybody's going to have their own opinion, but why don't we start with the top 20 guys, and Desi Rodriguez, right out the gate, an outstanding performer for Lincoln.
Right, and he's at number 20 of the top 100, and he had a really good season. But I think he really stepped up in the playoffs, but he was pretty consistent and solid all season, and I don't really think he got the kudos, you know, that he deserved throughout the year.
Desi was outstanding, the MVP of the PSAL Championship at Madison Square Garden. That victory, of course, the Rail Splitters beat Thomas Jefferson, and Rodriguez has a solid future, doesn't he?
I think he does, and I think he was a little underrated. He probably needs to, you know, maybe bulk up or something, but he's in high school, but I guess he should do that during the off season. But I think that's the only thing that's lacking for him.
Now, another guy that was outstanding was Jermon Faison for the Thomas Jefferson Orange Wave, making their second straight PSAL championship appearance. Unfortunately, they fell a little short against Lincoln, but Jermon was key in that ride to the championship.
Right, and that's another thing. This is why we like the top 100 the way we do it, because we give players like Faison an opportunity to be in the top 20, but that's based on what we actually see. It's not based on hype or anything like that. And he really played well throughout the year, and I don't think he ever got the credit that he deserved.
Now, I'm going to jump to number 15 on this list, and that's Shamik Shepard. Of course, he played for South Shore. They had an outstanding run themselves, and he's going to be a guy that you can see playing at the next level.
Well, Shamik Shepard, to me, I think he's probably one of the best athletes in New York City as far as athletic ability. You know, sometimes he's up and down, but as far as athletic ability and the things that he could do on the court, if he gets it all together, he could be one of the really, I mean, he's really a great player, but he just has a few things to work on. But as far as his athleticism, it's unbelievable.
We saw Shamik in that Jordan Brand Classic right across the street at Barclays Center. A great player indeed, and again, a solid future ahead for him. And his teammate, Terrence Samuel, headed to UConn, another guy that could really put it up on the offensive and defensive end, and he's a guy that was really key in South Shore making a nice run throughout the playoffs.
He was, and I think if he had he was a little down during the playoffs, and that's kind of how they kind of slipped. But during the season, he was solid, and he did what he had to do, but he's another really good player.
Now I'm going to move on to the Catholic High School Athletic Association. Bishop Laughlin, we saw them square off quite a bit against Christ the King. And one of their best players, Michael Williams, of course, he's a junior, and he's a guy that could really, really light it up.
Yeah, I think he kind of, he didn't really do what he could do. I don't think they really let him loose because they had other players on their team. But next year, I think he's really going to be something special. He's really good right now. If you're a scout and you're watching the game and you're watching a player like Williams, then you know you want that player on your team.
And we can obviously talk about another guy in that Bishop Laughlin squad, Kadeen Carrington. boy, what an athlete. And I saw him really put up some nice shots against Christ the King in that great game in Middle Village, Queens earlier this season. Talk a little bit about him.
Well, Kadeem Carey, I mean, he's a great guard, and that's partly why Mike Williams isn't shining the way he really should shine, because you have two guards like that, and it's really hard for both of them to shine. But they do a great job together, and they are two top players.
Now, as I move on to the number eight spot, Jaquan Brown, wings. Man, what could you say about them? They excited everybody. We saw them throughout the playoffs. And, you know, they really had a legitimate shot at getting to the Garden the way they were playing.
Yeah, they did. And Jaquan Brown, he had an excellent season. He is another, to me, I look at the New York City plays, and I really think a lot of these guys are underrated. And I really hate when I hear people say New York City basketball talent is down. These are, you know, it's just that I think scouts these days have gotten lazy, and they just read reports. They read what everybody else is writing. They don't actually go out and see the players. And so I think that's the bottom line, is scouts are lazy. And I'm going to put it out there. I think that's what the problem is, and this is why people are not getting as many looks from New York City.
Of course, New York City has had the reputation for producing some of the best point guards to ever play the game. So a lot of times, even the forwards and the centers are overlooked. But we've got some big men, very good big men, playing here in New York City. And those are some of the guys that we're acknowledging tonight.
Right. You have some. And when you go to the game and you see how big these guys are, it's like, wait a minute. I thought it was only guards in New York City, but you have a lot of big men, and they're playing strong. And I really do think if you could get 10 players, top players from New York City, and go play 10 guys from Chicago, I think New York City would beat them.
I've got to tell you, one of my favorite players in the city is Thomas Jefferson's Jaquan Lynch, a guy that FIU recruited heavily, and he's a guy that can really score. You know, Jaquan's a do-everything player. Saw him on the offensive and defensive end perform well for the Orange Wave, and I think he's going to have a very solid future at the next level.
Yeah, I think Jaquan, he's a tough player. I really like his energy in the game. You know, he's one of those guys that at the end of the game, you really want him with the ball. And I saw a few games that Thomas Jefferson had, and I saw the coaches kind of get on him and let him know, hey, you are the guy, you're supposed to be our man, so take over in the game. And then there were a few games that he actually did that. So he has that ability, and he's a really good guard.
Another great player for Lincoln, Elijah Davis, big body, goes hard on the boards, and he definitely performed well for Tiny Morton out there in Brooklyn and Coney Island.
Yeah, Elijah Davis, I really like him. I like his game, and you compare him, you know, or combine him with Desi Rodriguez, and that's really what made Lincoln really go. But Elijah Davis, he had a good season. He had a great playoff run, and that's a big part of why Lincoln won the championship.
Now we're gonna get into the top five now, and here's an exciting player we're talking about, Larry Beckett, at a Satellite Academy in the Bronx, guy that can do it all, and he certainly deserves to be in the top five.
Yeah, Larry Beckett, he's a tough player. He's one of those guys that you really have to, if you're gonna play against that team, you have to play again. You have to strategize to play against him. So when he makes you change your game, that makes a great player, and he's really good.
Well, a game MVP over across the street at the Barclays Center, Jordan Brand Classic, is the next guy we're going to talk about. Hassan Martin out of Curtis in Staten Island. Big man, knows how to go hard, and he certainly performed well in front of a sold-out crowd a couple of weeks ago.
Well, when you look at, you know, Hassan Martin, he had a great season, regular season. He had good playoff games. But then when you put him in a Jordan Classic and he's playing against top players, and he does even better, I mean, that's a sign of a great play. So he actually stepped up to the competition. So he did what he had to do, and he's definitely deserving of being in the top five.
Now, here's a guy that's on everybody's radar, has been since he's been a freshman in Coney Island, playing for Tiny Morton and that great Lincoln squad, and that's Isaiah Whitehead, the big guard, big body. Everybody's after him. Coach Jim Boeheim sitting in the gym over there, scouting him out, along with a lot of other schools that are interested in his services. When he gets to be a senior next year, Lincoln's going to try to make another run for the PSAL title.
Well, I think Whitehead, he's been getting a lot of attention for a lot of years, and I think that attention kind of, he did well, obviously, he did well this season, but I think next year he's going to do really well, because I think the attention kind of caught him off guard a little at this point. But I think next year he's really going to put it on, and he's definitely a top three player.
One thing about Isaiah, he keeps working on that body, but of course, his shooting improved throughout the season, and that's one area of his game that he definitely wanted to improve. I saw him hold it down for Tiny, and obviously he's going to be a factor in them making a run next year.
Yeah, I think he's going to be a big factor, and I think he's really going to step up his game next year. I think he's going to have a big season.
Now, when we talk about a player, a guy that's going to stay right home and play for Fordham University is the Catholic High School Association Player of the Year, John Sevier. Now, here's a guy that we saw him perform well in the Jordan Brand Classic, and he certainly is a player that everybody's got their eye on, and he chose to stay at home, which surprised a few people.
Well, he's definitely, I'm just surprised that he didn't get more big looks from, more looks from big schools, because he's definitely a serious player. And that, to me, that's what I'm talking about when I say scouts are lazy, because you'd rather just read what people are writing. You don't want to go out and look at the game. You don't want to watch the plays yourself. If I was a college coach or if I was a scout, I'd get all the top plays because I wouldn't be lazy. But he's one of those guys that you needed to look at and you needed to get him on your team. So Fordham was lucky to get that guy.
And we finally arrived to the number one spot. Now, here's a guy that doesn't get a lot of publicity, but a lot of people know about him, and he is Bashir Ahmed out of Kennedy High School. Boy, a complete game, a heck of a competitor, says his favorite player is Kobe Bryant, plays a lot like him too, and he just keeps getting bigger. When he fills out that frame, watch out.
Everybody's talking, it's not about hype when we talk about the top 100. When you talk about, I'll tell you, even John Sevier said, who's Bashir? Okay, you want to get on the court and you'll find out who he is. I mean, he's a big-time player. He has pro moves. He'll dunk on you. He'll shoot a jumper on you. He'll block his shot. He'll stick you to the backboard. There's nothing that he won't do on the court. And he's long. He's about 6'6". And I saw him last time. He looked like he grew. He looked like he's about 6'7 now. And when he's on the court, it looked like he's 6'9".
You know, one game that came to mind was when he played against Wings on the NYC Basketball Game of the Week, powered by Under Armour. He really yammed it on a couple of people. Outstanding dunks, really shook up the gym.
Yeah, and you know, the thing about him is, after a while, you start trying to double team and triple team him, but you still can't stop him. And that's the difference between him being number one and other players, because I've seen some of the other players get double and triple team and they can't do anything, they get stuck. He's not one of those players.
One game that comes to mind also is that Cardozo playoff game when he had to put the team on his back and do it all. Complete player. Can't wait to see what he's able to do at the next level.
That's right. And in particular, in that game, I was sitting in the stands and I heard people, Cardozo fans, were saying, who is that kid? He's like an all-star. They didn't know who he was. They said, he's playing like this is his gym. And that's exactly how he's playing. I think he had over 40 points in that game. I mean, and he did it in every way. And on top of the 40 points, he had about 4 block shots. He had about 17 rebounds. I mean, that was a big-time playoff game.
Bashir Ahmed says his favorite player is Kobe Bryant, and I can see why. Kind of mimics his game a little bit. Needs a little more weight on that frame, but boy, once he gets bigger, he's going to be dangerous.
That's it. I mean, I think he's dangerous now, but, you know, as you said, once he gets bigger, he's going to be unstoppable. And I think he's one of those players that can go overseas for 1 year, come back, and be in the NBA. He's that good.
Absolutely. Now, remember, you can see that top 100 players list in complete form on nycbasketball.com. All the members and coaches and opposing players weighed in, and that's how we arrived at that list. Of course, it will be available 24/7, 365 days a year on nycbasketball.com, the home of NYC basketball. And of course, we're done here from Buffalo Wild Wings at downtown Brooklyn, USA. Joby Smith, along with NYCSN President Vernon Jones. We'll see you next year. So long, everybody.